Greeks were well aware that the skeleton of the coral animal, that is the part that you make the jewelry out of, survives the animal. And in that sense, to the Greeks, coral represented immortality. It was a symbol of immortality. And perhaps that's why we today value it so much, not just because it's lovely, but it's something of lasting value, something that will in fact outlive us.
Dr. Richard Grigg is recognized as the world's leading authority on the ecology of precious coral.
People often wonder what is coral, and are very surprised to discover that it's an animal and not a plant. It looks like a plant because it grows in the shape of a tree, but it's actually an animal. It belongs to the phylum Selenorata, along with jellyfish and the hydra and soft corals. They're all interrelated in a family. Corals generally are divided into two major classes, the reef corals in shallow water, which are very porous and therefore not valuable for jewelry, and then the deep water varieties, some of which are very hard and can be polished into jewelry. And these include the black corals, the pink corals, bamboo corals, gold corals, all in different families of the phylum, but all anatomically related. Of course, one reason precious corals are precious, so valuable, is because they're very dangerous to harvest. There's inherent dangers in diving, whether you're in a submarine or scuba diving. For example, off Maui, where you've got very strong bottom currents and the black coral beds are at depths of, say, 150 to 350 feet. Diving under those conditions is just really on the edge. Of course, today, since we're concerned about the conservation of the resource, we've developed models, mathematical models, to estimate how much coral it can be taken out of a bed. And one of the first companies to actually utilize that technology was Maui divers here in Hawaii. They not only developed a submersible to go down and allow one to selectively harvest the coral, but they in fact harvested it in such a way that it was selective and they only took a small percent so as to allow full recovery of the beds. Maui divers is probably the finest design merchandise in the world. There are some companies in Italy that rival it by virtue of the gold and the design and the historical artistry that goes into it. But the Maui divers has what they call a designer line, which is a very one-of-a-kind fine line piece of jewelry or a line of jewelry. So it's extremely high-grade, high-quality material.
Cliff Slater is president of Maui Divers of Hawaii Limited. He oversees the design and manufacture of one of the world's largest producers of coral jewelry.
We're here in our design department, and this is where the process really begins. And what we have here, just as samples, this is a gold coral tree, the raw material from which we start, as is here a pink coral tree. And we take this material and together with gold nuggets, here's some 14 karat gold, and we put these together and finish up with a gold and coral and diamond ring. And that process really begins here in the design department with the original design and with the production of the first model. And the model, the original design, is where the process really begins. The culmination of the designer's work is with the production of the finished model, very precisely engineered, and this will serve as essentially the prototype for all the jewelry we'll make of this style from now on. The next stage in the process is to make a rubber mold of the model that we've just made. Then we open up that rubber block and remove the metal piece from the inside, and we're left then with a rubber block with a cavity inside. And that cavity we
inject hot wax under pressure, and when the wax cools, we open up the rubber block and remove the wax pattern. That wax is going to be an exact replica of the original metal piece. Once we have our wax, we then take many waxes and form a cluster of waxes, which we then surround with casting plaster, which is rather like plaster of Paris, but it has some special properties to it. Then, when we've got that solid block of plaster with the wax inside, we then melt out the wax from the internal part of the plaster, which is where the term comes from, the lost wax process. And once we've got a perfectly clean interior to the plaster flask, which we've done in very high temperatures in special ovens, we then have a plaster flask with a perfectly clean cavity internally, and that is what we inject molten gold into. And the molten gold is injected in the temperature of around 1750 degrees, and when the gold inside the plaster has cooled down sufficiently, we then take that whole block plaster with the gold inside and we put that into cold water. The cold water has the effect of exploding off the plaster from the gold cluster and exposing the gold. And then we have the basics. We have the basic items on which we're going to work. We cut those off into individual items, and then we start the process. First process is to remove the crust from the outside of the casting. And then we go further down and have the casting polished. Then we have to go into coral cutting, and we cut stones to precisely fit the castings. When that's set in, then we move on to the diamond setter, and the diamond setter is setting a pave diamond in this particular ring, where we're taking 9 different sizes of diamonds and paveing them together so that you get a nice even flow to the setting. Quality comes from having the attitude that absolutely anything can be made better, and that's what we're attempting to do.